Epicenter Live, Epicenter Videos, and we are here with the most serious player in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Hello, Rain.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. My congratulations, you will go to semifinals and who knows, maybe to finals.
Yeah, who knows.
And you are the one of the players who are very rare showing the emotions.
Yeah, some say that.
Why?
I don't know, I just think that I'm a calm person, both outside of the game and in the game as well.
Okay, can I ask you a question? When it will take a lot of time and you will get your child and you will tell about the greatest people in the sports ever, who it will be?
In esports?
Yeah.
Probably the likes of Olaf Meister. There is something special about him. He's a legendary player. And then you also have Pasha. He's just a great guy. He's always nice, he's always friendly. The same with all the VP guys. They're always so friendly people.
So it will be Counter-Strike players, yeah?
Yeah. For me, it will be Counter-Strike players.
Okay, for sure. As I know, FaZe was started from you. So yeah. You like the face of the FaZe.
You can say so.
Can I ask you a question? How many impact for the roster challenge for this guy or this guy can bring him, maybe we'll call him or something like this, as your impact?
Not so much my impact. I think in the start, when we were switching a little bit, I was a part of the conversations with that and that. But lately, I haven't been like a big part of it. I don't want to kick people. It hurts to see friends go because everybody I play with is still my friend, I feel like. And I have good relationships with them, so I don't want to break it. It's been mostly like a team decision every time, I feel like. Everybody's on the same page and everybody understands what needs to happen.
But you're still the face.
Yeah.
Like a face clan. How do you think, is it possible to finish your career inside the face? Because we have no, still, we have no like one example that one man started with one team and finished with one team.
Yeah, I don't know. My big dream in the end of my career would be go back to Norway and create a Norwegian team. So not now, but later on in life, to try to get them back on the scene. It's been a while since Norway had a team, since I was in LGB. It was the last time we had one. So go back to Norway and make a team would be something I would like to do.
But let me think. No, LGB, it was completely Norway team.
Yes.
So you want to rebuild it?
Rebuild something like that. Maybe not LGB, but... a team with new young players from Norway that are hungry.
If it's not secret, why?
I don't know, it's just, I want to do something good for Norway, not just for esport. The last years I have been very secluded from Norway. I have said no to interviews from Norway, I haven't done much. So I want to give back to my country as well and show them what esport really is.
It's very nice to hear.
Yeah.
Tell a little bit about esports inside Norway. Is it possible to play as you want? Is it nice internet connection or something like this? I understand that it's nice internet connection, yeah. Of course. But if it's possible, just a little bit about esports in Norway.
So internet in Norway is very good. You can get up to like, I think 5 gigabytes up or down or something. So that's not a problem. I think the problem we have is the recent years has been better, but before it was kind of looked down on. People didn't like people playing games. You had to go get a job and stuff like that. But now it's changed, of course, because now it is a job to be an esports player. You make good money, you can live in Norway. But before, I think you didn't make enough money to actually stay in Norway because it's very expensive.
I understand. But what is for you? It's more responsibility, it's more your job, it's more your faith, it's more your think. What is for you after all?
Cisco?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's like a job I love, it's a dream job. I love playing games, so even if I don't practice, if I don't go to tournaments, I play games. Even if it's, I play some other games in CS, but mostly my mind is always on CS. Even when I go to sleep, I'm like, oh, I wish I could play more, but that's how it is.
Can you please tell us how many games you have inside your Steam? What are the second
game? How many games I have?
Yeah, how many have?
Oh, I play PUBG.
Okay.
A lot.
A lot?
Too much, too much.
Did you enjoy
it? Yeah, I really enjoyed it. I started with Armor 3. It was before PUBG.
It's a very nice game, by the way.
Yeah, it's like Battle Royale there as well. And then PUBG came out, so I played that. And then now I play this Blackout. I don't know if you heard about it.
Yeah. And do you know that like a creator of PUBG, he was the one guy who invented like this mode?
Yeah, in Armor 3. Yeah.
Very nice to hear it. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know about this. Okay, let's just imagine. Just imagine that sometime, someday, you meet Gabe Newell.
Gabe Newell?
What do you say to him? What would you say to him? Just one phrase, like, Gabe,
Hire more people for CSGO.
My friend. My friend, it's a perfect phrase. Yeah. It's a real great phrase. So maybe sometimes you think that maybe, we cannot say it like a for sure.
Yeah.
Maybe we need a bit more people to pay attention to CSGO.
I think so, for sure. I think people need to be more open-minded as well that work with the game and listen to the community feedback a bit more than what they do. So recently they have done a lot more stuff and, than they used to do, but I think they need to make these operations that they used to do.
Yeah.
Because they haven't done it in a while. I think the community missed it. It's something that is needed in CS.
But for pro players, I understand that nothing in our life is not ideal.
Yeah.
But the game right now, it's a lot of changes. We saw a completely different game than 6 years ago.
Yeah, of course. Especially the money change they just did is huge. You can either have a really good start to the game or you can get completely destroyed.
One time, maybe it was like 3 years ago or 2 years ago, I saw a video on the internet when you, a guy from the FaZe Clan in the United States, he watched your achievement in Kyiv.
Yeah?
Yeah, did you watch this video?
Yeah, I remember. It was all of FaZe Clan was watching, I think.
In like all of FaZe Clan, yeah. In a big house, like they're jumping in a swimming pool.
Yeah.
Something like this. How did you make like this real? How do you meet each other?
From the FaZe Clan guys?
Like, yeah, they from USA, because the FaZe Clan in USA is something unique.
Yeah.
It's a lot of people, a lot of YouTube creators or something like this. And here in Europe, we understand that like for us, FaZe Clan is just a CSGO team. Powerful CSGO team. And there in USA, it's some kind of culture.
Yeah. We started talking with FaZe because of Makelele, because he knew Tico, who was in FaZe. And Tico introduced us to Banks, who eventually bought the team from G2 back then.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Okay, if you have some advice for young people who want to achieve something in CSGO, just one.
Yeah. Play qualifiers and try to qualify for FPL. If you get into FPL and you're a good player, you have a very good shot at becoming a pro player.
You know, I have to ask it because a lot of people are speaking about this, a lot of people discussing it. Do you really think that the FACET and the FPL, of course, it's some kind of start of your esports career right now and you have no way to do it some other stuff?
No, you can definitely do it without. If you have a good team, you play with friends, even though you make it far in qualifiers, I think people can get your eyes open for you and recruit you. I think this Cirk from NRG, I think he just came, I don't even remember if he was in FPL, like I never heard of him, about him, and then he goes to NRG and he is a superstar there.
Yeah, he's
so
nice.
So you can definitely or get pro without FPL, but it's a lot easier with FPL available.
All of our life is not easy.
That's true.
It was very nice to speak with you. I hope that sometimes we will meet each other again and speak about other things. Guys, stay tuned. This is Epicenter.